Good morning, everyone. We welcome you all to the day two of Basic and the Smart Innovation Conference. We are honored to have with us is Mr. Amit Kumar. He is the co-founding partner at our venture fund and a SEBA registered Kata AI focusing on the early stage sector and mystic startups in India. With over 20 years of experience in venture capital, finance and business scalability, he is qualified chartered accountant. Amit sir led the investment strategy, due diligence and portfolio management at our ventures funds, providing mentorship to back entrepreneurs. In October 2022, he co-founded the Medan Fund of INR 150 crore after successfully securing investments from the multiple sources. As the former CFO of a B2B e-commerce startup, he played a key role in scaling the business from 4 to 300 employees and raising $22 million in funding. Additionally, Amit Kumar sir brings extensive expertise in management, consulting, business strategy, risk management, audit, and system and processes. We welcome you to Vivekananda Business School, sir, and we would like to ask you a few questions.
Sure.
As a co-founder of the Medan Fund in 2022, what were the key challenges faced in raising funds from multiple investors, and how did you basically overcome it?
Okay. Being the maiden fund, obviously, this is the first time we are doing it, although we run a very successful and a large investor network. When we went to the market, I think we didn't face a lot of challenges per se because people typically knew us. Yes. And the investments that they wanted to do in the fund was not so difficult. So yes, we just went to people, spoke to them. But what we really did to begin with, we went to first people whom we knew before.
Okay.
Whether it's my batchmates or my partner's batchmates and people who trust you with the money that they're going to be giving and investing into startups.
Yes.
And then we did a lot of road shows. We went to various cities and especially tier 2, tier 3 towns, which was very, very difficult to attract people. But I think the critical piece here was the awareness that you need to give people when they want to do angel investing.
Okay.
A lot of people do not know about angel investing.
Yes, exactly.
And people who know are obviously doing with us or with the other people. But people who do not know what angel investing is, you need to make them aware of a new asset class and how they can make loads of money by investing into startups.
Okay.
So go talk to them, do road shows, and that is how we attract investors into
it's
the fund.
It's basically your pitch that should be very convincing.
It's more than, it's surprising that when people are pitching to us for funds, we are now also pitching to people for funds.
That's lovely, sir. I would like to ask you the second question. Can you share the specific examples of successful investments or notable achievements for the startups you have backed and the role you played in their growth?
Right. So, one, whenever you invest in a startup, the proof of the pudding is not in the money that you're investing. The proof of the pudding is in the returns that you're going to be getting.
Yes, exactly.
And not for yourself as well, but also for the investors.
Yes, exactly.
So when the returns happen or when the exits happen, that is where everybody makes money, whether it is our ventures making money or the other investors associated with us making money. So we have done about 17 exits till date.
Okay.
And the IRRs have ranged from 30% to 90%. But notable ones where we have returned a lot of capital to investors has been a company called Keto, which is in the social crowdfunding platform.
Yes, yes, exactly.
There people have got multiples in excess of about 50.
Yes.
So which means that if somebody had invested 100 rupees, now they are obviously getting 5,000 rupees.
Oh my God.
Actually more than that. To be honest, I don't want to reveal the actual number.
Okay.
Then there's this company called Testbook, which is in the edtech space.
Okay.
The angel investors' equity was acquired by a new incoming investor. Their people also made in excess of 10x. So that is again one of the notable achievements that we have in terms of our exits. So when I talk about achievements in angel investing, for me the only achievement is the exit or the money that I'm returning to the investors.
Okay. So that's basically you need to be very sure when you pitch to the investor, and you should have a planned demographic of how you're gonna get in the money, plan it out, use it, execute it, and what will the results that will be coming.
Absolutely.
Exactly. So one more question I'd like to ask. Given your expertise in the management consulting, how do you see the role of strategic planning and risk management in the success of the early stage startups, and what advice would you typically provide for that areas?
Awesome. I think very importantly, when people start any company, first of all, they are not aware of the nitty-gritties that are around governance, compliance, etc.
Yes, exactly.
But more importantly, they do not even sometimes know how to make a good financial model or a business plan.
Exactly.
What they know is to make a nice PPT, which
yes,
all MBA students or founders can easily do.
Yes.
Because of the fact that that is what they have been taught in college and also what they learn from their peers is to make a nice presentation. But only a nice presentation does not cut the chase out here. The important thing is that you should know your numbers, and that is why you should make a good business plan, a good financial model, because as investors, what we are honestly interested is not just looking at a nice PPT, but how are you going to deploy the money that I am going to be giving you?
Okay.
And while doing that and after doing that, how are you going to get the returns so that those returns also can then be given back to the investors or to us? So that is what a lot of founders sometimes miss, is the expertise of finance or financial management. Over a period of time, they need to learn it. The earlier they learn, the better.
Yes,
because exactly. If they are good with the product, they're good with the go-to-market strategy, but they're not so good with finance, it does not give the requisite confidence to the investors that, okay, fair enough, they will handle my money well.
Yes.
And exactly. If they cannot do that, how will they actually return me money with returns or with multiples? The second thing, which I think is very critical, is to know about basic compliances, whether they are direct taxes, indirect taxes, the importance of filing those on time, so that later part of their journey, they do not face any issues with those departments coming after you. For not doing basic compliances and levying you penalties and interests, which becomes a hassle of sorts. I think that is something which they should be keeping themselves away from. And it is not a very difficult task. You appoint professionals to do that. It's not necessary that you need to learn everything about income tax or GST, but you should appoint requisite professionals who can handle it for you. And you will get professionals from across the board in terms of their costs, I'm talking, because people may argue that compliance is expensive.
Yes.
It's not the case always. You'll always find people who will be ready to do with smaller checks.
Yes.
And if you're able to instill that discipline from day one about being compliant, it goes a long way when you are raising funds in the future also. When I'm saying raising funds, means when they're raising funds not only from angels but also venture capitalists in the later part of their journey.
So I feel, sir, that basically you also need to stand out if you have to take the funding from the investors. It's not just the basic practice of the previous company that we are following for the same.
Absolutely.
Right, sir, I would like to know your experience, and if you can just share experience of Vivekananda Business School, and what insights and the recommendation would you like to give to the students of Vivekananda Business School as well?
One, I really like the way it has been organized. I think I like the entire premises, I think, which is good. Then the panel discussion that I was a part of, very insightful and interesting, had great panelists with me, so which made it more interesting. The Q&A from the students really shows that they're all entrenched into the mode of entrepreneurship, so they really want to become entrepreneurs, and their questions were nice. In fact, quite a few of them met me after the session, and they have promised to send their pitch decks to me so that our team can evaluate and see if we can try and fund some of them. To the budding entrepreneurs, like I said in my panel discussion also, one, build a product which is liked by the market and not by what you are building. So it's not that you love the product, the market will love the product.
Yeah.
Second, don't run after valuation, run after value creation. Valuation will follow always.
Okay.
And third, most importantly, if you are an entrepreneur and you fail, don't think that you are a failure.
Yeah.
Your enterprise has failed, but the entrepreneur in you will never fail.
Yeah.
So continue with the journey of entrepreneurship, even if one enterprise fails, and you will become a successful entrepreneur one day.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you for all the lovely insights, and thank you for your precious time at Vivekananda Business School. We hope to collaborate with you again in the future. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.